Woke-kulturen når nya höjder. Den nederländska författaren och transpersonen Marieke Ringwald har hoppat av uppdraget att översätta den välkända poeten Amanda Gormans poesi till holländska. Men varför det, undrar ni säkert? Jo, eftersom Amanda Gorman är en svart kvinna. Och om man är en svart kvinna så kan man inte ha en vit översättare. Ja, enligt woke-mobben i alla fall. Ja, tyvärr så tickar inte Marieke tillräckligt med offerboxar för att göra woke-crowden nöjd. Å andra sidan så vet vi allihopa att det är ganska svårt att göra de människorna nöjda. Men helt ärligt, vilken värld lever dessa människor i? De lever uppenbarligen i en värld där människor ständigt ska dömas och värderas utifrån sin hudfärg och andra helt irrelevanta faktorer. Vad händer med att människor ska dömas utifrån sina handlingar? Vad händer med att se människor för deras gärningar? Men låt oss ta och använda woke-mobbens logik här. Den som ska översätta Amanda Gormans poesi till svenska är ingen mindre än artisten Timbuktu. Men vänta nu. Om man tittar på bilden på Timbuktu här så tycker jag nog att han ser ut som en man. Dessutom är han faktiskt några nyanser ljusare än Amanda Gorman. Jag vet inte, jag tycker nog att detta blir lite problematiskt. Jag menar, hur kan Timbuktu som en ganska ljus svart man förstå hur det är att vara en svart kvinna? Eller hur? Nej, men helt ärligt, woke-kultur vill se att vi människor bedöms utifrån vår hudfärg. Och det är inget samhälle jag vill leva i. Jag vill på riktigt ha ett samhälle där människor och konsten framförallt är fri. With me to give her perspective on this is Eva, a Dutch political commentator. Welcome, Eva.
Hi, Amy. Thank you.
So, Eva, what's your view on this? I mean, we have a Dutch translator here who has said no to translating Amanda Gorman's work simply because he's too white.
Well, to complicate matters a little bit further, he is this person is a non-binary person, so, you know, have to stick to the rules there. But yeah, this person didn't exactly say no. This person was forced kind of in a way to say no, but then said, oh yeah, of course, I'm so sorry to have upset many people with, you know, the fact that I wanted to translate this, even though this person is a translator. So it's it's very strange. It's another one bites the dust for the woke mob, I suppose. And it's just ridiculous, basically.
So it wasn't even Amanda Gorman who said no to this translator, but it seems as though the woke mob, as we like to call them, they have a lot of power here. I mean, people are obviously caving to their will, right?
Exactly. No, actually, frankly, apparently the team, Amanda Gorman's team, or maybe even she herself, asked specifically for this person. So can you imagine? It's like, you know, why not, you know, just give her wishes? But apparently, yeah, the skin color counts for more. And it's been successful, this sort of attack on this translator, and they have stepped down. So yeah, it's very successful indeed.
And where has the logic of all this? I mean, where is the logic anymore? I mean, aren't we supposed to judge people based on the talent they have and the character that they have, not on superficial things like skin color? I mean, where has our society gone?
You'd think so, right? And it seems to be progressively getting worse. So we've seen this sort of this demand for representation in politics before. I don't know about, probably in Sweden the same thing, but we've seen that people are like, oh, I want a woman to represent me in parliament because a man wouldn't know my issues, or I want a black person to represent me because I'm black, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So we've seen that before, but now we're entering into, you know, a whole new level where it's apparently impossible for someone to translate your words because they don't have the same lived experience as you, which I think is honestly, it's just, you know, it's so unfree. It's very illiberal the way that they are controlling not just the way we have to view the world, but also the language that we use. And it's getting really, really out of hand. I mean, even the word poet, apparently, I learned today reading into this story, Amanda Gorman is not a poet. She is a spoken word artist. So there you go. Fun fact.
Yeah, of course. I mean, the logic, if you want to call it that, of the left just continues to confuse all of us, I think. Thank you so much, Eva, for joining me today. And thank you, everyone, for watching Ricks.